Hi, I'm Kevin Hart. And as you know, I'm a comedic rock star. A part of living that rock star life is having a bunch of friends that are athletes. They're busy, I'm busy. Being they were all so busy, the only way I can talk to these people is right here in this ice bath. Welcome to Cold as Balls. Today's episode, I'm sitting down with my guy, Nerlens Noel. All right. I see you went with a generic basketball bottom.
Let's get right in. Don't waste no time. Let's get right in.
Brother, I don't need you to tell me what to do.
Okay, that's right.
I know what I got to do. Ooh, yeah.
Take your time.
First of all, Mark Cuban, man. Let's talk about Mark for a sec. What are you expecting to get from Mark that you didn't get in Philadelphia?
I'm expecting to get a lot of game.
Locker room's a lot better.
Oh, yeah. It's a little better.
They say y'all got everything in that locker room.
Yeah, it's an upgrade. It's an upgrade for sure.
Philadelphia, you saying we didn't have shit?
They had Dreamcast. I mean, we got Xbox Ones over here.
See, that's the problem. That's the problem in Philadelphia. We don't have enough shit in the locker room. Look how excited this man just got talking about we got Xbox One. Mm-hmm. He ain't say shit about the weight room. He's talking about the Xbox.
Dip it in. Come on, Kev.
I thought that
Come
was
on, Kev. Dip it in.
Yeah.
Yeah, we good.
That's
man.
Comfortable.
Yeah, let it
You was a crazy kid? Crazy city kid?
No. I was a good kid, but you know, everything around you can, you know, really
can influence what you're doing.
Most definitely.
So you're basically trying to talk around the fact that you had friends that was assholes. You had bad influences.
Yeah.
I did that so you can understand, and I'm gonna ask you the tough questions on Cold as Balls. Don't run away from these questions.
I ain't running from no questions, Kevin.
What players do you think you have little pieces of?
A player I really look up to, you know, especially being from Boston, is Bill Russell.
Bill Russell, the oldest man in the world. Yeah. How old is Bill Russell?
Damn.
Bill Russell got to be 300. Somebody Google how old Bill Russell is.
83.
That's bullshit. He's 183. If you ever say a wrong answer and make me look stupid on my show again, you're fired, and you can go fuck yourself. Sorry you had to hear that.
It's all good, man. It's Bill Russell.
You and KG almost made being tall and skinny cool.
I think it is pretty cool.
No. Y'all.
You almost are getting to the point where being a midget is pretty all right, too.
First of all, we don't use the word midget on this show. We use the correct term as little people. Second of all, I'm petite.
Fun size.
Petite, which is a masculine way of saying short.
Right. Yes.
University of Kentucky. A lot of legends done came through Kentucky.
Mm-hmm.
Do you consider yourself one of the legends come through Kentucky?
I definitely feel like I'm one of the legends, one of the alpha dogs that came through there.
Alpha dog. Alpha dog. It's funny, because I got recruited.
You got recruited?
Yeah.
To go
by,
to
University of Kentucky. This was, I'm not sure, you were probably young. But it was a little thing, but I turned him down. Oh, the program wasn't for me. But I thought you should know that I could have went down that same pipeline. I chose a different route. I chose stand-up comedy. But if I had have chose basketball, I would have went through the University of Kentucky. And we would have both been alpha dogs.
Yeah.
We would have been two alpha dogs in a hot, cold tub. Do you consider yourself a ladies man?
I consider myself a gentleman, yes, sir.
A gentleman?
I'm gentleman, yes, sir.
Why you go to R&B voice?
I ain't all about the ladies. Well,
why you just switched to R&B just now? Your whole f***ing mood just changed.
I know, yeah, come on.
We was talking and you said, I consider myself a gentleman. You got a female right now?
I do.
Well, how long you been together? How long your lady been together?
We've been.
That boy damn near choked. He damn near choked himself just now.
So give me some advice on, you know, your love life and, you know.
Relationship advice?
Yes, sir. I need that.
You know, a happy woman is a happy home.
Mm-hmm.
Happy wife, happy life. That's what I believe in.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just say yes. Yep. Yes. Mm-hmm. Will do. Yes, I can. What'd you say? Got it. Done. Huh? Coming right up. What'd you need me to do? I'm on it. Huh? You want me to go right now? See that? That's just a plethora of the word
like
yes.
That. I'm gonna take that.
Do that, bro. Who's the biggest asshole that you played against?
Biggest
asshole?
My God, DeMarcus. He's my
DeMarcus?
Homie. He's an asshole.
He wears very tight jeans.
Not an asshole, those person. Like,
too late,
answers.
He said it.
His
I
answers.
Agree.
His
DeMarcus,
answers.
You're an asshole.
He's an
Don't
asshole.
I ain't taking nothing back. DeMarcus, he feels like you're an asshole on your team, okay? Biggest hole now that you moved to Dallas that you think that you're gonna have to deal with? What about Dirk?
Dirk is a good ass dude. He's
a good dude?
I mean, he's just as funny as you, honestly.
There's no way he's funnier than me. Or as funny as me. That's impossible.
No, he'd probably sell out. He'd probably sell out an arena, though. Yeah. No, that's...
It's actually impossible.
No, I'm dead serious. That's
it. Ready to go all the way in, Kev?
What are you talking about?
We're going all the way in.
Well, I tell you what. I don't answer a man when he looked me in the eye and say, you ready to go all the way in. I don't know what the fuck you are talking about. I don't know what you think this show is, but that's not what we do here. Okay? So I don't know what happens in the locker room at Kentucky and these things, but it ain't gonna happen on this show. What you wearing, a size 36? What size is your sneaker?
16, bro.
Jesus Christ.
It's not bad.
Oh my God.
Definitely got some 18s, 19s. I had
Jesus.
Right. Yeah, I'm all right, bro.
God. Now, even though you left Philadelphia, I definitely got a lot of questions about Philly. You know, like I said, that's my hometown. Like the face of Philadelphia, man. Joel Embiid, was he sad to see you go?
Yeah, that was tough, man.
Did you try to say like one of those sentences where he can't really finish all the words? You know, it's okay. It's okay, you know, things happen. You got to trust the process. Say the fucking sentence, man. We were at dinner. I'm spitting all over the food and everything.
So I'm gonna ask you some questions now, see how well, since you know you got a nice little feel for what I'm about. What pickles are in the NBA draft?
Easy question. Number 38.
38? Kev. Yeah. Kev, come on, Kev. Hmm?
First round, you went number one. You went number one, man!
What position do I play?
Power forward, more in the center. Because you rotate.
See, Kev, you're doing a lot. It's running around.
I'm not running around. I'm telling the truth. Because in the NBA, they change it. You're center. I'm going to go with center. Hi, that's the right. Mother get your ass back. They have
to
do that.
It don't faze me, dog.
Yeah, well, you don't have somebody that obviously has it out for you. I'm dealing with a full-blown racist over here. You obviously don't like black people. Cat's out the bag now, ain't it? Jesus Christ. All right, here's a question for you. If you weren't playing basketball, what would you be doing in general?
In life? If I was my FBI agent.
An FBI agent? Well, it wouldn't be no secret.
CSI.
Here come the tall FBI. There you go. No, you're talking about the guy in the trench coat? He's an FBI agent. What would I be doing? I'd probably be a thug. Because I was always a killer.
Always.
So I'd probably just be back to killing. Hmm? Because I was a cold motherfucking killer in my heyday. As these, if you don't believe me. Mm. Favorite celebrity?
My favorite celebrity, I'd have to go Will Smith.
Will Smith.
Yes, sir.
From Philadelphia.
Yeah, you're damn right.
It's just weird when you got a guy that you're sitting right across from that you've been talking to. Could have easily said me and I would. I'm taken back by it, but you chose Will. I get it. Who else? Give me one more.
One more?
Favorite comedian.
I don't know.
You think is?
Chris Rock.
Okay.
Chris Rock.
Got it. When I say University, you say Kentucky. Wildcats. Yeah. Wildcats. Yeah. Y'all didn't do that?
We don't do that on this side. No, Kev, nah.
Hi, I'm Kevin Hart. And unless you hate laughter, click and subscribe. And if you do hate laughter, then you're a monster.